Hi, Herman Williams here. I want to talk to you today about online golf lessons. A lot of you ask me, hey Herman, I've seen all your videos on YouTube, I've been to your blog at hermanwilliamsgolf.com. I'd like to get some of that same kind of help. So I've had a student volunteer for me. He took a recent private lesson here at our golf academy. His name is Will. We're going to go through the exact video golf lesson that we gave him with all of the swing analysis, all of our software markups, all of my audio. And then we'll finish with kind of the finale where we'll demonstrate a few things in here in the studio. So I'm going to sit down at the computer now, show you everything that goes on in one of these lessons. And if you like this, this may be something you'll want to email us your own swing. We'll go through that for you. And I've also got a video tutorial which shows you all about how we want you to film your golf swing. So let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so we're here with Will now in our computer, and Will, what we want you to see is, we started you out here. These are just going to be some iron shots with the 7-iron, and we'll start with this down the line view, and we'll probably pull up another swing here beside you in a second, but I'll tell you the things that we look for when we're doing the video here. We'll sort of draw a line right here, sort of down from your tailbone, check where the knees are here. Shaft angle, line for posture. Okay, and then we'll tell you what we see here. So knee flex wise, I think you're in pretty decent shape. We like the knees. No more flex than what you have here. Your rear end's in the right spot. You've actually got a pretty good posture here. Your back's fairly straight. You're bowed over enough. And I like the fact that you have your hands away from your legs. You've got roughly what would amount to about a fist width of space right in here between your hands and thighs. And that's really good to give you room to make a good downswing. We can probably tell, I'm going to go ahead and get rid of all the lines here. Well, we can probably tell how your right hand grip looks like it's up underneath the club a little bit in what would be classically described as a strong grip. But we'll get a closer look at that when we move around to the front view of your golf swing. So we'll just draw a single line now. And the way I'm drawing that line, it goes from the neck of the club through your right elbow, just one single plain line. And this is going to be the average line that most golfers will swing on for a downswing. It so happens that it's pretty close to your initial setup angle. My favorite position for shaft in the setup is basically to have the shaft pointed at your belt buckle. So you may have your hands just a little high here, but I don't think that's a problem. I'm not going to ask you to change that at all. So let's start your backswing here. We'll start with takeaway. Actually, I'll wiggle the camera a little bit there, getting my tripod set, but we're okay now. So we bring it back, and we can already see some of the effects of your grip. The club face is a little bit closed here. You can see how the head is tilted down or the face is pointed down. Generally, for tour players, we probably see the face angle up like this, where it matches your torso angle. We'll carry on into the top of the backswing. Kind of lift the right elbow there. Somewhat short backswing. There's not much wrist hinge going on here. And, you know, the thing we'd really point out is what you have here is a closed club face. This is probably the most significant feature in your swing. And in our interview prior to your lesson, we noted that you're tending to hit the golf ball very low with a mixture of low pull hooks as well as some occasional blocks out to the right. It's all coming from the club face. What we'd expect to have right here as we look at your left arm angle, we expect the face of the golf club to be parallel to that. We can see how the toe is just pointed off in a completely different direction, the face facing down. We drop in on the downswing. You're now trying to approach that plane line. We can see the hands stay above the line while the club head dips underneath it. And as you now start to approach impact, essentially the club head is traveling on a severe inside-out path. Strike it here. This might be a little bit off the toe. You can see the left elbow sort of pop out kind of low over there in the finish, then the club come around. You can see the ball leave there on a pretty low trajectory, which is probably your standard shot right now. All right, we'll move back around. And everybody tells me they just want to be consistent and start getting more consistency in their swing. I'll show you how this video looks. This is not the same swing. This is a different one. We'll see right here the club face still looks closed. Closed at the top, right elbow's kind of high. Drop it in right here, trying to save it. We've got the club head kind of back behind the hands, sweeping from well inside the ball, going out through it. Kind of bounced in, hit this one a little fat. There goes the left elbow popping out on the side. So I'll tell people, there's two classic examples. This ball is a grounder beating along the ground. The other shot looked pretty good, although it was low. But the similarity of both swings is pretty close. There's not very much difference in the two. We run around to the front, now we really start to see the issues. So we have this, what we call very strong grip here. If I kind of draw a circle around the hands there, we could come in here and kind of blow that up a little bit. But you see how the right hand is underneath the club and the back of the left hand is facing straight out at us. That's classically a very strong grip. And that just means both hands are turned to the right on the golf club. It's causing a serious forward press here in the shaft of the club. We can do a measured angle on that. So that shows up as a 105 degree angle. Consider the fact that a 90 degree angle would be vertical here. So that's 15 degrees of shaft lean right there. It's no wonder we'd hit low shots, because we're going to have that 15 degree shaft lean at impact if we're not careful here. So let's just go ahead and play the swing. But initially here, I'd want to get rid of the strong grip, get rid of the forward press. Stance width looks fine. Ball position's a little bit back in the stance, but not terrible. Go ahead and make a wind up to the top. Yeah, here we can see how the backswing's somewhat abbreviated. Pretty simple pivot. Slight little drift over here in the knee, but that's minor. We'd probably work on that in another lesson. We've got almost no wrist hinge. You know, we typically would see wrist hinge bring the shaft maybe where I just drew that red line. So we'll start down now. Again, all the wrist hinge is gone. We've just drive the hands forward. And we're virtually back where we started with that big forward pressed look here. We'll see what the angle looks like now. Let's see, having trouble reading that. Yeah, so we're still about, if we looked at a 90, that's saying 63, so do some quick math on that. That's still 27 degrees of shaft lean right there. You see how we towed this one? Hand's still way out in front of the golf shot. Still way out. Let me get rid of these other lines real quick. So this is just completely trying to hang on to the golf club out here and keep driving the back of that left hand to the target so that face won't roll over. And that's all a function of the grip. All right. Let's do this. Let's put side-by-side swing in here. So we have Luke Donald on the right, and we'll put one here. Iron swings here on the left. In fact, wait a minute, let's see if we have a, see if we can find a driver swing for you here. Okay, so we have your driver swing over here. So we'll have both of you guys make a swing. We look at the setup. Luke's bowed over just a little bit more in the upper body. But your arm hang is similar. Your shaft positions are pretty similar here. Watch the takeaway. See how Luke keeps the club head out in front of the hands. I don't have you guys synchronized here. I'll do that in a second. But we arrive at the top of the swing, and we can see, this is what I wanted you to see about how Luke's club face would look here. Here's the left arm. That's the line for that. Let me change that drawing color there. That red shows up a little better. And then his club face, it gets, sort of disappears in the trees over there, but the club face is roughly the same angle as the arm. Now we'll go over here and look a little closer at your swing for a second. I'm going to finish getting you right to the top. Okay, right there. All right, so your arm angle, like so. And of course, the club face, nowhere near being parallel to that. Totally different angle. All right, we'll go ahead and start these swings down. You can see how the shaft sort of falls a little bit behind Luke right there. Hands stay a little closer to his body as he clears out. Here we're at impact. All right, both swings there. Okay. See his legs, you can see his left leg cleared out a little more firmly there, how it's braced up behind his body. Will, your left leg's still kind of flexed and stuck underneath you a little bit. So. Yeah, honestly, your body motion is pretty close. We just ask you to clear that hip a little bit better. But we know the big deal, you know, the big difference between you and a Luke Donald is how you look on that face view. So let's close this up. Come back around. We'll do a front view here. And we'll put a different player on the front. This is Yuta Akita from Japan. Just a swing I filmed at the Masters. Didn't pick him for necessarily any particular reason, but it's a similar build to what you have, Will. Now, he has a driver here, and you'll notice he has a somewhat strong grip in the left hand, but nothing like where you are. And notice the big difference in the shaft position, how the shaft is in a much more neutral, what I'll call neutral position here, where it's not leaning forward so much. No forward press. Just a good standard bracing in the feet. And even for a guy with a strong grip, I mean, we can see that the back of his left hand is tilted in. But look at the right hand. I want to get rid of those lines. Even for him, he has what I determine as a strong right hand grip, but it's nowhere near where yours is. Your right hand is completely up underneath the club, where your, what we'll call the trigger finger, right up in here, this forefinger, sitting all the way up under the golf club and coming around the other side. So we'll play the swings here. Of course, here this gives you a big difference in the wrist hinge potential. And you can see how the right leg for Yuta has stayed more braced inward this way, where yours has drifted just slightly to the right. But again, I might work on that on a totally different day. I would love to see you try to get some good wrist hinging here. Start down. Get you guys more synchronized here. So now Yuta has the hands in a similar spot to your own. You'll see there's a little bit more wrist cock still in there, a little bit more hinge. You see the dynamics in his leg action. He's moved to the left a little bit harder and started to clear his body. And impact. Will, you're very flat-footed. Bring Yuta into the impact zone. We can see how he's off the right foot and the left hip's cleared well out of the way. We continue to play. I'll slide your swing over so we can see it. You see, Will, where you hang on to the shot, I'll advance Yuta's swing a little bit further here. See a little bit more crossover in the forearms where he can release the golf club. Okay, so that's our analysis. Now we'll come in and look at a few close-up shots. We looked at the driver. Here's where I wanted you to see how the forward press has the club face literally tilted down towards the ground. You can see the de-lofting nature of the face there. Here we've got the same look as you bring it into the ball. Now the front view here shows the dramatic forward press here, and we've got some drives here that literally didn't go 2 feet high. We'll play this swing. Again, very compact, pretty limited backswing. Come into the golf ball, hands way out in front, and here you can see the result. This golf ball is driven in. The driver probably has 0 degrees aloft at that impact position like that. Okay, so let's talk about what we're going to change here. We'll get here and make a live demonstration for you. All right, so starting out with grip, we want to get the hand more neutral position, clapping on the side of the club essentially. So I'll start you with a neutral left hand position. Want the heel pad right on top of the handle, thumb pad right on the top. Want to avoid that hard turn to the right that you have currently. So heel pad on top, thumb pad on top. The V of the left hand just between the cheek and the shoulder here, but nothing excessive. Right hand, I want you to come in and basically cover the left thumb. Want the crease in here of the lifeline coming down from the top. Left thumb should not be in view anymore. When we make closure here, I want your right pinky laying on top of the knuckle. We don't want to interlock. We're going to lay right on top. You'll notice a fairly pronounced trigger finger now. In your current grip, the knuckle of the forefinger comes out on the other side of the golf club. I want your trigger finger down the back side of the shaft, so it'll look like something like this. You'll see that first knuckle out in view. and the V for the right hand should run straight up towards your chin. That'll go a long way to cleaning up all the problems. Now, back away from the camera just a second. When we get into the setup, I now want the shaft perfectly neutral, straight out in front of your body. Just bow forward and put the club down. That'll get rid of the huge forward press and the de-lofting problem. All right, that takes care of the grip and the setup. And then we want to look into the backswing. I'll do that from front view like so. We've got to increase your wrist hinge here. We basically just need the wrist to fold in. And the feeling I want you to have for that is pushing the handle away from your body. If you can get the butt of the handle pushed out from your chest, that'll help cock the wrist as well as keep the width in the arc. Now we just want to store that angle coming down. And now for the first time ever, maybe in your life, let the arms cross over. We're going to let them release a little bit here as though you're going to throw the club away. With the old grip and the big forward press, we had to hang on to everything through the front just to try to stop it from hooking. And again, the shots go low no matter what, even if we catch it solidly. So great neutral grip, neutral shaft position, full wrist break at the top, release at the bottom. If I have a prediction, I think you can tackle the grip pretty quickly, get the neutral setup going, start to get some hinge. If you're like most players, you'll probably still try to hang on because your old swing will probably show up. If you hang on with the new grip and the setup, you're going to block and push and slice balls to the right. So don't be alarmed if that happens for the first, I don't know, few balls or maybe even a day or an hour. Don't know how long that'll last, but as soon as you're capable of letting the hands release, those shots will start to take off straighter and higher. Okay, so good luck with that. Come see me again soon.